Whether it's for economic reasons, for pest control, or simply to introduce an interesting addition to a home or estate, humans have introduced numerous animal species to new, unfamiliar habitats. Sometimes they introduce species that didn't have much of an impact on native environments, but all too often, as happens when humans interfere with nature, it went disastrously wrong. Stay tuned to number one to find out which ones you might already have as a pet. Number 10, Yellowstone Wolves. Now, this is a perfect example of how people's actions and decisions can have a continuous negative impact on local environments. Thanks to human involvement, the last Northern Rocky Mountain wolves at Yellowstone Park were killed by a government order in 1926. It wasn't until decades later that scientists and conservationists realized the mistake that their decision had on the environment and began the process of reintroducing them back into the area. However, the wolves' impact since reintroduction into the ecosystem has created both positive and negative outcomes. So, what went wrong? Well, some people blame the type of wolf introduced. However, it should be noted that both the Northern Rocky Mountain wolf and the Northwestern wolf, which was introduced, are both a subspecies of the same species. Although the reintroduced animal is slightly bigger, reproduces in larger numbers, and is more aggressive. But overall, it's unlikely that this is a massive contributor to the issues caused by their reintroduction. Nevertheless, they have caused numerous problems in the area, and that area has expanded as the pack grows to include Idaho, Montana, and Colorado, not to mention the Rocky Mountain area of Wyoming where they were introduced. Not only are farmers losing livestock, but the elk herds in the surrounding regions have been decimated, with a 40 to 50% decrease in herd size due to the wolves feeding on them. This is definitely an example of how things can go disastrously wrong when humans try to introduce animals into new environments. Number 9, Burmese pythons. The Burmese python is a great example of how bad things can get when you introduce a predatory animal into an ecosystem that doesn't have any natural predator. Native to Southeast Asia, this snake has been introduced to southern Florida, where it has widely been kept as a pet. Although it is now believed that there could be a few thousand of them living in the wild, the growing population of the wild Burmese pythons has the potential to cause ecological disaster for native species, as they don't have any predators in that region, other than humans. They have also developed an appetite for local endangered species, causing concern for conservationists. They've even been known to take on an alligator. In order to try to combat the sheer number of pythons inhabiting the waterways, local authorities have called on hunters to help keep the numbers down. I hope I never see one of these in the wild. No, thank you. Number 8, the Nile Perch. The Nile perch is a species of freshwater fish that is native to the Congo, Nile, and Niger rivers, as well as other bodies in the surrounding area. As one of the largest freshwater fish, it can measure up to 2 meters in length, making it a massive catch. It has been introduced to several other freshwater lakes, the most notable being Lake Victoria in East Africa, where it is considered a textbook example of the negative effects of humans introducing animals to new environments. In all, it's believed the Nile perch has contributed to the near extinction of several hundred native species. Initially introduced with planned economic benefits to the local fishing industry, some communities bordering the shores of the lake were not properly equipped to deal with the changing ecosystem, and they suffered a massive socioeconomic impact as a result. This example shows how species introduced for commercial purposes can have a devastating impact on the local environment and can even negatively impact local communities as well. At least there are plenty of fish to eat, that is, if you can manage to catch one. Number 7, domestic cat. It might surprise you to find domestic cats on this list, but humans have introduced them to numerous environments, and they are actually on the list of the 100 worst invasive species in the world. As a pet, cats have brought lots of love and joy to millions of people who keep them as pets. But they have also had negative impacts on the environment, especially in the United States. Introduced by European colonists, the population of domesticated cats has increased dramatically across the continent, especially in urban areas. And while the house cat isn't typically an issue, keep in mind that there are over 100 million feral cats that now live in the wild. Although the wild cats, descendants of runaway pets or abandoned animals, cause a lot of problems, it is both wild and domesticated cats that prey on local wildlife. Just because a human feeds a cat doesn't mean it won't hunt. I mean, cats are hunters after all. So combined, they eat or kill a lot of native and non-native species. But it's not just what they eat that causes problems, just their presence can be problematic for birds because, let's face it, who would want to raise their young next to a predator's lair? Yet, no matter how much of a problem cats cause, it's highly unlikely their status as one of the most popular pets is going to change anytime soon. Number 6. Siberian Chipmunk. The Siberian chipmunk is native to places like Northern Asia, Central Russia, China, Korea, and Northern Japan. It was only recently introduced to Europe in the 1960s when it was a popular pet. By the 1970s, their population had increased dramatically, and they inhabited many suburban forests and urban parts in countries across Europe. Unlike some introduced species, the Siberian chipmunk did bring some benefits, like the dispersion of seeds and fungi spores. But they've also brought negative impacts with varying severity. They eat crops and annoy gardeners. They compete with native species for food, and they even bring diseases such as Lyme disease that can be dangerous to both humans and pets alike. In all, this species hasn't caused much of a widespread disaster as other examples on this list, but these cute little creatures have definitely raised environmental concerns. But did you see it though? I think I want one now. Number 5. Small Indian Mongoose. Native to South and Southeast Asia, the small Indian mongoose doesn't mind living in close proximity to people and has been introduced to numerous places like Hawaii, the Bahamas, Cuba, Costa Rica, Jamaica, and Colombia. You know, the list goes on and on. This species was introduced to try to combat agricultural issues. For example, in Hawaii and the Caribbean, they were introduced to kill the rats that infected cane sugar productions. But they've also had a continued impact on the local environments, especially ground nesting birds. Ironically, the small Indian mongoose didn't have the desired impact on the populations of black rats that the locals were hoping for. Instead, they have had a drastic impact on several local native populations of birds, reptiles, and amphibians. Number 4. Gray Squirrels. The gray squirrel, native to the eastern half of North America, was introduced to Britain in the 1870s as a fashionable addition to estate parks. The main impact the gray squirrel has is on the population of red squirrels, which are, in fact, native to countries across Eurasia. In 2014, there were estimated to be approximately 2.5 million gray squirrels in comparison to only around 100 to 150,000 red squirrels. So, how have the gray squirrels been so successful in decimating the native red squirrels? Well, not only do they compete amongst one another for territory and resources, they also carry squirrel pox virus, which spreads quickly through the red squirrel populations. It got so bad in the UK, in 2017 the Wildlife Trust sought 500,000 new volunteers to monitor numbers, record locations, educate children, and even kill populations of gray squirrels. All we can hope is that they manage to find a sustainable solution, otherwise the UK's red squirrel population will become a part of British history. Number 3. The Common Rabbit. Native to southwestern Europe and northwest Africa, the common European rabbit has been introduced to numerous environments, with only harmful results for native vegetation and wildlife. The first recorded evidence for this species being introduced to a new ecosystem is from the Roman times, when they were introduced to the Balearic Islands and Great Britain. In more recent times, they've been introduced to some places in the Hawaiian Islands, islands off the coast of southern Africa, Australia, and New Zealand. In Australia, they have devastated the environment, and they are considered one of the most significant known factors in species loss. It's not just the environments that they impact, they also cost the Australian economy millions of dollars. Likewise, in Britain, roughly 40 million rabbits cost the economy more than $360 million a year in damages to crops, businesses, and infrastructure. It's clear that the rabbit has caused some pretty bad problems for some of the countries it's been introduced to, but they are also beloved pets, and in the UK alone, there are at least 800,000 pet rabbits. So it's kind of a love-hate relationship. But in all, they are definitely one of the most expensive examples of humans introducing species to new environments. Number 2. Africanized bees. Also known as the killer bee, the Africanized honeybee is a hybrid of Western honeybees, which by itself was originally produced by crossbreeding the African honeybee with different European honeybees. The unexpected result was a meaner, more defensive species of bee that is much more likely to attack something that they perceive as a threat. It's no surprise then that they are widely feared by the public. Contrary to popular belief, the sting of the Africanized bee is not actually more potent than any other honeybee, it's just that they are more dangerous because they are more easily provoked. And when they are provoked, they bring friends. Lots and lots of friends. Regardless of their impact on humans, they are considered an invasive species to the Americas, where they have spread from Brazil to Mexico, Texas, Florida, Southern California, and numerous other southern states, where they are causing various problems for people and the environment. And let's face it, what's worse than killer bees? Number 1. Cane toads. The cane toad is the world's largest toad, measuring between 5 and 10 centimeters in length. Native to South and mainland America, this toad has a massive appetite, and that's how it found its way on this list. In the early 20th century, its species was introduced to Queensland, Australia, in the hope that it would combat the rise in beetle numbers, which were devastating the sugarcane fields. This led them to introducing the cane toad, and thanks to the successful introduction of the species in other parts of the world, people thought it would be a good idea to introduce them to Queensland. Initially, they arranged for about 100 toads to be flown to Australia, and the rest, as they say, is history. Now their population numbers well over 200 million, and ecologists are left scratching their heads on exactly how to get rid of them. The problems they cause range from the depletion of the native species that the toads snack on to the poisoning of pets, especially dogs, who unfortunately like to lick toads and eat them as a snack, completely unaware of their poisonous backs. There's no way to know for sure the exact long-term effects that cane toads will have on the native populations in Australia, but one thing scientists are confident about is that there is no evidence to suggest that they actually affected the cane beetle populations that they were brought to fight in the first place. So, what do you think about these invasive species? Any in particular you're familiar with? Let us know in the comments below, and don't forget to like this video and subscribe for more interesting topics. Take care!